Hello, Cyberman here. Since the last year, I've been making a procedural game called Medieval Life. It is a simulation game similar to The Sims or Stardew Valley, but with cute 3D pixel art graphics. In this game, all the terrain, houses, environment, and NPCs are procedurally generated. I've been using Unity to develop this game. I think Unity is great to develop classic games, but it's not so fitting for procedurally generated ones. That's why I decided to craft my own engine from scratch. After looking through numerous engines, frameworks, and libraries for different languages, I decided to use Veldrid. Veldrid is a low-level graphics library that lets you write code that works on Vulkan, DirectX11, OpenGL, and Metal. The API is similar to the Vulkan API, so all the concepts are translated almost one-to-one. I started by creating my first cube. To draw a simple cube on the screen, you need more than 300 lines of code. You must define absolutely everything that your video card should do. The next following step was to make, you guessed it, two cubes, and to add a camera system. Next, my objective was to be able to load 3D models. There are several 3D file formats. I choose the GLTF file format because it is an open format, modern, well documented, and it was developed by the Kronos Group, the same creators of OpenGL and Vulkan. Also, it supports storing meshes, skeleton animations, and even complete scenes. At first, I started using a library called SharpGLTF that let you read GLTF files, but it was too high level for what I was looking for. So I ended up developing my own GLTF parser and integrating it with my engine. The next goal was to load animations. To load an animation, I need to load the data related to the mesh itself. Then I need to load the hierarchy of nodes that will be acting as the bones of the character. For example, here I draw a cube in each bone of the character to be able to see it. After a lot of trial and error, I got it working. The next step was to be able to show text on the screen. Rendering text is a very complex task. I got lucky and I found a font rendering library for C# called Fonts-Sharp. The library is 100% engine agnostic. This means it doesn't render the text in the screen for you. You need to implement your own renderer and pass it to the library. The library will render the required characters in a big texture atlas and then call the renderer you provided in order to draw those characters on the screen. This library supports Unicode characters and even emojis, so that's great. The next main thing I wanted to have is to be able to use my mouse to pick and select objects. In my game, Medieval Life, the player will be able to interact with objects like in The Sims, but in first person, so I need a way to be able to detect what object is under the mouse cursor. There are two main techniques to achieve this. The first way is to use raycasting. This is the method that most engines use since it can be used not only for mouse picking but also for collision detection. The problem with this method is that the algorithms involved are too complex. There are physics libraries that do the math for you, but I think that including a full-blown physics library to use only raycasting is a bit like an overkill. Also, this technique does not work well with skinned meshes or with meshes that have transparent texture like this tree. The second technique is using an ID texture. Basically, you need to assign a different ID to each selectable element in the scene. Then you draw everything in a different texture using a different color for each element. And after you draw everything, you check what color is in the pixel that is under the mouse cursor. And then you use that color ID to know what object has selected the player. I used this technique with another games I made in the past, so I had not much trouble implementing it here. The last thing I needed to implement before moving on was shadows. I've never made a shadow system, so at first I wasn't sure how to implement it. I followed with the tutorial made by Team Metrics. He explains how to create a shadow mapping system from scratch in OpenGL, and he also develops games and has a great channel full of weekly devlog. You should follow him. The link to the video is in the description. The next few days I spent improving the renderer and making a small material system. It was the first time for me making something this complex, so I asked a friend, Matthias Goldberg. He's a main contributor of the Ogre rendering engine, and he knows a lot about rendering and low-level optimization, so he helped me a lot to improve the renderer architecture. Then I started by trying to load the character models I had in Unity with an animation. Everything according to the plan. After that, I implemented an algorithm to generate texture atlases at runtime. Normally, you need to combine all the textures you use in your game in a big texture atlas. In medieval life, I create my texture atlas at runtime. After that, I was ready to start porting my game from Unity to my own game engine. I started by porting the procedural generation part. After that, I copied the code for the 3D visuals from my Unity project to the new project I was making in my own engine. I had like 2000 errors and warnings that I had to fix manually. I replaced all my reference to the Unity API to my own APIs. There are more than 200 classes in the project, so it took me a while. But after almost 3 whole days of effort, I finished. So I pressed the build button and... that definitely wasn't according to the plan, but it was something. I spent another 2 days fixing all the errors and then I got it working. It runs on DirectX11, Vulkan and OpenGL. I don't know if it works on Metal because I don't have a Mac, so I can't test it, but I think it should work fine. So that's all. I still need to add some other things the Unity version had, like the objects, like the bed, table, this thing, whatever it's called. I also need to add the water. Transparent objects must be drawn in a different way, so I need to improve the render first before adding the water. If you liked this video, please leave a like and press the subscribe button. It will really help me a lot if you subscribe to the channel, and also in this way you can stay up to date with the development of the game. Also please leave a comment, it really gives me a lot of motivation when someone comment my video. So see you everyone, until next time, bye!